Thousands of farmers protesting agricultural reforms in the country stormed the historic Red Fort on January 26th. This was the day when the farmers who have gathered around Delhi for the past 2 months and more had planned a tractor rally parallel to the Republic Day parade. The Red Fort was vandalized, and in the process of these people marching to Red Fort, breaking all police cordons, about 400 policemen got injured. These incidents were immediately condemned by the farmers' union leaders. The opposition too condemned the violence, but blamed the ruling party for instigating the violence. That is one of the allegations they made against the ruling party. Their claim is that Deep Sidhu, who led the farmers run amok to the Red Fort, was a part of the BJP, and that was a conspiracy to break the farmers' agitation, which was going on peacefully and which is going on peacefully for the last few months. These farmers who have gathered in Delhi protesting over the changes made to the farm laws know Deep Sidhu since long. It is not that Deep Sidhu is a stranger or he is unknown to them. He is a well-known Punjabi singer and actor and model rather, and he was actively involved in the campaign in the last few months. He was there promoting the cause of the farmers, and he was the one who carried the religious flag of the Sikhs, the most sacred religious flag of the Sikhs, to the Red Fort and planted it there. Some of the farmer unions, which were a part of the group protesting, now disassociated themselves with the farmers' agitation, and they have gone back to their places. The other farmers are still there. Now, to say that there are no politics to the farmers' unions and farmers' agitation is wrong. But by and large, it is small and marginal farmers and the others who have gathered there who are seeking the repeal of the farm laws and farm laws alone. Most of the farmers who are still there are just simple and plain anti-farm law agitationists. But there are several people, several associations of farmers which are involved in this, who are deeply connected to the political parties. Hence, there is a political agenda too to the farmers' agitation. There are 35 farmers' unions which are now there sitting on dharna. Out of the 35, 31 of them belong to Punjab alone. The rest to Madhya Pradesh and Haryana. A smattering of the farmers' unions and their representatives from other parts, perhaps 3-4 other states, are also there. Rajasthan farmers tried to join them sometime back, but they went back again. Now, out of the 35 unions, at least 10 of them are politically associated. These are all offshoots of various political unions of various political parties. 6 of them are affiliated to left parties of various denominations, including CPI and CPM. The rest are affiliated to AAP and Congress and other political parties. Now, these political parties, which have sent their representatives to the ongoing dharna, have, apart from the farmers' agenda, their own agenda. They are not just seeking repeal of the farm laws, but also seeking something else. Because most of the political parties which try to encash upon various anti-government or anti-BJP movements in the country earlier and which failed miserably are now seeking to bank upon the farmers' agitation. These political parties try to exploit demonetization issue. They try to exploit anti-car protests. They try to exploit other farmers' smattering agitations which came up in the country earlier. They could not succeed. This farmers' agitation in this particular farmers' association, they see a godsend opportunity and they want to make the most of it. We should also remember that apart from their involvement in the farmers' association, some of the groups, that is the political groups, which are affiliated to the political parties, are trying to bank upon these groups and this particular agitation because of the upcoming elections. There are elections to five states this year itself: Kerala, Puducherry, Tamil Nadu, West Bengal and Assam. And in 2022, we have elections to Punjab and UP assemblies apart from Uttarakhand and Goa. Of course, 23, there are elections to some more states. 24 also, there are some more elections. Of course, 24, we go for general elections itself. These farmers' unions, which are apolitical and which do not allow any political party leaders to come to them and address them, at least they have kept them at bay so far, and which do not seek any political intervention at any point of their agitation, should be aware of these political parties. Should also know that there will be always an attempt to discredit them by the ruling party. At the same time, there will be an attempt by these political parties to exploit them. If they are becoming pawns in the hands of the politicians and politics of this country, they know very well that they have been so for long in this country. What they are seeking, what the farmers are seeking right now, is not just a rollback of these three laws. In fact, they want this whole program to halt. It calls for a deeper discussion, a greater discussion on the very structural reforms of the agriculture. There are several issues to be addressed, and it is not just three farm laws which need to be addressed now, even if the government is willing. It is not just a rollback of these farm laws. It is a complete overhaul of the farm laws that is required in this country. Otherwise, farmers don't benefit. Those who are protesting over the three new farm laws now also know that it was under the previous laws that thousands of farmers have committed suicide in the country. Farmers' suicides have not stopped because of one particular law or another one. Their suicides have been going on, and farmers in Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Punjab, UP have all been committing suicides due to various reasons. An estimate says that their annual income is less than 20,000 rupees, that is hardly $270. Imagine $270 per annum and or 20,000 rupees per annum. This is the amount they get. And most of the farmers do not get fair price. Despite the assurance of MSP, minimum support price, most of these farmers do not get that. And there are several natural calamities that come in the way of farmers getting a fair price. There are cyclones, there are rains, and the grain gets damaged, they do not get the price. But it's a private market also, they never get the price. And the market mandis, on which they are heavily dependent, never fully justify the roles for which they are created. Farmers' plight and farmers' problems and travails continue in this country because of the sheer apathy of the governments. Governments or any of the political parties that headed the governments never really took care of the farm laws or farming community in this country for long, rather right from our inception. Hence, farmers keep facing these problems. So to expect that any of the political parties which enacted these farm laws or paved way for the enactment of these farm laws in the past through their liberalization policies, through their globalization policies, if someone comes and tells them, look, we are here to support you, should the farmers believe in them? Be it BJP, be it Congress, be it any of the regional parties or any of the other left parties or so. They have never stood by the farmers. Apart from waging agitations, they never could prevent suicides of farmers. They never could assure proper income to them. Under these circumstances, farmers should know better. more than us.